Welcome to the Friendship Baptist Church in the Colony. I'm Senior Pastor Gregory C. Trotter, and I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our live streaming program here at Friendship Baptist Church. Let me take this opportunity to welcome you into our worship service. Our prayer is that you will be blessed and that you will receive that blessing that God has in store for you. So sit back and enjoy the worship service. We welcome you to the Friendship Baptist Church in the Colony.
Good morning, and praise ye the wonderful God that he is. Good morning, Friendship. Oh, it's been a good morning and better than that this morning, because it's just so much have went on. And we just thank God for it being so good to us. You know, I look around and I see, you know, the temperature change, and Pastor said casual dressing, you know, but the Lord always has something in store in his heart for us, because sometimes we just go through casual things in our lives, and sometimes the burdens are a little bit heavier, and sometimes we just know that the only thing that can save us is prayer. So you have to just continue to pray through each and everything that you go through. I'm coming to you from John chapter 4. Starting at verse 10, Jesus answered and said unto her, If thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that said to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. May the Lord bless the reader, hearer, and doer of his holy word. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, once again, dear Father, we find ourselves between these walls, dear Father, in your house, dear Lord. Father, knowing that the church is in our heart, dear Father. And God, we know that we carry it with us each and every day, dear Lord. So, Lord God, we just ask that you carry us throughout this day, dear Lord. Father, everything that we do, dear Lord, that you will bless us, dear Lord. Lord, that you will forgive us for the sins that we have committed, dear Lord, knowingly and unknowingly, dear Lord. Because, Lord, we are your children, dear Father. Lord, we pray for our pastor this morning, dear Father, and pray for the preached word that he will bring, dear Lord. Father, the sun is shining out, Father, so let it shine into his heart, dear Lord. Lord, let it shine, dear Father, throughout this sanctuary, dear Father. Lord, someone right now needs a turning around in their heart, dear Lord. Father, bless this choir, dear Father. Bless these ladies as they'll come and do devotion this morning, dear Father. And Lord, let us all say hallelujah just one time for you, dear Lord. And Lord God, we just ask that you bless us now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, and thank you, Lord.
Good morning, Friendship. Isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord? Just one more time. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. We are your devotional team this morning, members from the Women Enrichment Program. We will have Sister Cece will bring to you the scripture, and Sister Ramsey, the prayer. At this time, the scripture.
Good morning. We'll be coming from 1 Peter 3 and 9 from the NIV version. Praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ in his great mercy. He has given a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade, kept in heaven for you, who through faith are, and shredded by God's power until the coming of the salvation that is ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you greatly rejoice, through now a little while you may have to suffer grief and in all kinds of trials. These have come so that your faith of great worth than gold, which perish even though refined by fire, may be provided genuine and may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Though you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy, for you are receiving the gold of your faith and the salvation of your souls. Glory be to God.
Sister Ramsey.
Let us bow our heads and prepare our hearts to enter into the throne room of grace. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come before you this morning in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, asking Lord God forgiveness of omission and commission of sin in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, we come before you in the name of Jesus, just thanking you, Lord God, for another opportunity to assemble together in your name, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you in advance for manifesting your presence in this edifice on today, Lord God. We thank you in advance, Lord God, Heavenly Father, for the one that will come down and ask, what must I do to be saved, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you on today, Lord God, for releasing destiny and purpose, Heavenly Father, into the lives of your people, Heavenly Father, on today in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God, for the one that will stand in John's shoes, Heavenly Father, and bring forth, Heavenly Father, the bread of life on today, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, the unchanged word of God, Heavenly Father, that transforms lives, Lord God, that brings forth healing, Lord God, that brings forth deliverance, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, the one that brings forth breakthrough, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We pray and ask in the name of Jesus that you would have your way in this service on today, Lord God. Heavenly Father, we give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, and thank you, God.
Good morning, church. Good morning.
Good morning.
Why don't you stand with us as we enter into praise and worship this morning?
Amen.
We were made to worship God. All he wants us to do is to glorify his holy name today. Give him praise and adoration. Won't you join with us?
I feel your spirit all over me.
All right.
I feel your spirit all over me. It's in my hands, in my head, and down in my feet. Yeah, I feel your spirit all over me.
All over me, it's in my hands, in my soul, and down.
How many of you have something to worship the Lord for today? Not only because of who he is, but has he done something good for you today? Let's raise our hands in exaltation. Raise our spirits in praise today as we think on God's goodness.
me through hard trials. He brought me through tribulations. Never let a day go by and unrealized. Had not been for the Lord who was on my side, back was against the wall, looked out for me. He heard my cry and rescued me. Never let a day go by and unrealized.
Let's say that again.
He brought me through hard trials.
Ooh.
He brought me through tribulation.
Never let a day,
go by and I realized. Had not been for the Lord who was on my side, back was against the wall, looked out for me.
Sit and think just for a moment just how good God is. Yeah, it could have been me, it should have been me, it would have been me. If it wasn't for the blood, it should have been me.
Oh! This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning. Giving our praises to our Heavenly Father, respect to Reverend Trotter, other ministers on the roster, Sister Trotter, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Announcements for July the 31st, 2016. Wednesday Bible study will be held 9:30 a.m. and 7 o'clock p.m. Join us for Wednesday morning prayer, 6 a.m. Central Standard Time. Dial in #641-715-3580. Access code 376-789-POUND. August 6th, Evangelical Training Association Classes, Part 1, 9 to 11 a.m., Room 2302. Part 2 class will be held August 13th, 9 to 11 a.m., also in Room 2302. Contact Sister Sylvia Bethea for details. August 10th, Awana Teachers and Volunteers Meeting at 6:45 p.m. Contact Sister Ruby DeRoe for additional details. Back to school supplies. Donations are needed for our back to school supplies giveaway. School supply lists are available in the Family Life Center. August 13th, Health Fair, Back to School Rally, School Supply Giveaway, 9 to 1 p.m. August 16th, Interested parents, there will be a meeting at 6:30 p.m. to enroll students in the FBC tutoring program for the 2016-2017 school year. The program will begin September the 14th. Please contact Sister Bianca LeBlanc or Sister Stephanie Lawson at fbctc-tutoring@outlook.com. Our youth ministries at fbc-tc.org. August 18th, Child Abuse Prevention and Awareness Training, 6:30 p.m. Contact Sister Pat Whaley in the Church Administration Office. August 19th through the 20th, Singles Ministry Symposium, Friday, August 19th, Singles Team Building, 7 to 9 p.m., and Saturday, August 20th, 9 to 3 p.m. Contact Reverend Michael and Sister Sheila Burke for details. August 20th, BIBLE Seminar, 8 to 1 p.m. Register today. Breakfast and lunch will be provided. Babysitting also available. Registration is required. The Empowering Boys Mentoring Program are in need of licensed barbers who are willing to participate in our free haircut voucher program in support of the FBCTC 2016 Annual Black Back to School Youth Rally. If interested, please visit www.friendshipbaptistchurchofthecolony.org or contact Brother Corey Russell. Church announcements can be found in your bulletin board, or you may log on to www.friendshipbaptistchurchofthecolony.org. Memorable quote from the pastor's desk: whatever you dislike in another person, take care to correct in yourself. These are your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Reverend Gregory Trotter and the body of Friendship Baptist Church, thank you and have a blessed day. Thank you.
To my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to our pastor, Pastor Trotter, and to all the members who labor with him, all the ministers who labor with him, to our First Lady, Sister Trotter, and to the family of Friendship Baptist Church, I'm here to welcome our guest. If you're a guest visiting with us this morning, would you please stand and remain standing? Christine Smith, on behalf of the Hospitality Ministry, we would like to say welcome to Friendship Baptist Church. We are so blessed that you decided to join us this morning. And if there's anything that we could do for you while you're here, please do not hesitate to ask. And know that you are not here by chance. This is where God wanted you to be on this day at this time. Well, our Friendship family, please stand and welcome our guests. Thank you and have a blessed day.
And the people of God said, Amen. It is indeed a blessed privilege to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. To have laid down last night and to rise up this morning with life, health, and strength. Amen. No matter how bad your health is, somebody's worse than you. Amen. So we ought to be thankful for things being as well as they are. Amen. I want to say to those of you who are visiting with us today, welcome to Friendship. We thank God for your being here. And please come back and worship with us again. Those who are joining us by live streaming, we welcome you into this worship service as well. Amen. We thank God for a successful vacation Bible school. Amen. This past week. Amen. We had somewhere around 1,300 who came out and shared with us in Vacation Bible School this past week. And we say thank you to Deacon and Sister Wallace. Amen. And to the Wallace family for all of the hard work that they put into Vacation Bible School, and to every volunteer. Amen. No matter what you did, even if it was sitting at the table, signing people in, opening the door, welcoming someone, or showing somebody where that class was, we thank you for your volunteer work this past week. Amen. Just to reiterate a couple of our announcements, BIBLE, this is our new members orientation, will take place on August the 20th, and that will be from 8 to 1 o'clock, I believe. So those of you, our new members, if you have not been through new members orientation, this is an opportunity for you to come and get all of your classes done in one morning. So that will be on August the 20th. You need to sign up. Deacon Peterson will be, amen, the young man on the door back there. Amen. He will be at a table over in the Family Life Center. If you are a new member and you are ready to attend our new members orientation, please be in prayer for several of our members who've had loved ones to go home to be with the Lord. Sister Jessie Jones, her daughter was funeralized on yesterday. Brother Cedric Dunford, our musician, one of our musicians, his sister was laid to rest on Friday. And then Sister Rachel Jones' mother passed away earlier in the week. So please be in prayer for these members who've had loved ones to go home to be with the Lord. Amen. 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 Pray for them, because we don't ever know, amen, when it will be our time. Amen. We want to acknowledge today that Sister Christine Smith, the young lady who just welcomed our guests, this will be her final Sunday. Amen. She's decided to go back home to Alabama. Amen. So we are going to miss, amen, our trustee, our friend, amen, Sister Christine Smith. Amen. As the Lord has directed her, amen, to go back south. Amen. And to go home. God bless you going back south. Amen. I believe I'll stay out west. Amen, amen. We'll see you when you come back, amen, to visit with us. We are going to miss Sister Christine. She's, amen, been a very, very intricate part of Friendship, and we thank God for all of your hard work. Amen. Her daughter Madison, amen, going away to college. Amen. Mama wanted to be close. I know that's what it is. She just wanted, amen, to be close to Madison, but that's okay. Amen, amen. So we are praying God's good success on the both of you. Please be in prayer for, amen, several of our members. They are away today, taking those young people away to college. Amen, so that they can get that rude awakening. Amen, that I warned them about. Amen. They think now I'm on my own. Amen. And I don't have to listen to nobody. Amen. I can make, like my grandson told me, I can make my own rules.
I said, okay, on rules. Amen. You'll soon find out, amen, about making your own rules. Amen. Amen. So please be in prayer for our young people as they start this new journey, amen, in their lives. Amen. All right, our deacons are going to come at this time along with the ladies of our church as we prepare to receive our tithes and our offering. Here at Friendship, we believe in tithes and we believe in offering. The tithe is what we owe God. The offering is the seed that we sow. And we are going to give back to God that which so rightfully belongs to Him. Amen. Amen. After they pray, you'll be in the hands of our men who are ushering today. Thank God for our men today. Amen. As they are ushering.
Let us pray. Dear God, our Heavenly Father, we come to you, Master, thanking you for your goodness, thanking you for your blessings. Thank you, Father, for those who give. Thank you, Father, for those who have a desire to give but have not. Bless, bless, bless as only you can. We pray that this offering will be used for the uplifting of your kingdom on earth. We will give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. It is in the name of Jesus we pray. And the church says, amen.
Time to come, drop it, leave it, let it go. Bring it to God. It's prayer time. Let us pray. Father God, God of creation, God who stopped one day and said, light be, and everything came into existence. God who took a ball of nothing and made this world to be light. So we just come saying thank you, and we give you the glory this morning. Who blew breath into mankind, and man became a living creature. We thank you this morning. God, who on the midnight, the 30th of August, decided August 31st we'd be around this altar. We just say thank you this morning. Somehow we realize that it's not our goodness but your mercy. God, we realize that it's not what we've done but what you asked us to do. Realizing that we still got work to do. So as we come right now, we say, right now, thank you, Master. And we come saying, we realize we hadn't done all the things you've told us to do. We've gone contrary to some of the things you've charged us to do. We have not done all the things you told us. So we right now, we say, forgive us of our trespass. We say right now, forgive us of the things we didn't do. Forgive us for last night we didn't say to somebody, that's not the right way. Last week we stopped and turned our eyes as a blind eye from injustices. We say, forgive us of our sins. Last week we passed somebody and did not lend a helping hand. We say, forgive us this day. On last week, Masters, somebody was going in the wrong direction and we decided that we would turn a deaf ear to them. We say, forgive us this day. We've decided that we'll go along with the status quo. Forgive us this day. Oh, forgive us, Master, for we've just decided that we're going to let be what is rather than say it as God said, let it be. So we say, take it away from us. Create in us a clean heart and renew in us a right spirit that we might serve you in spirit and in truth. Now, Father, somebody has come to this altar today deciding that they trust you so much they're going to put it all in your hands. And they're going to do what you say over in 2 Chronicles, seek your face. Sometime, Master, we want to put it in your hands because we want you to take care of it. But we never want to look in your face to see that you're an all right God, that you're all righteousness, that you're perfect and your mercy is everlasting and your justice is just as well. So let us see your face this morning. Right now we look at a glass darkly and we're not seeing it right. Let us look into your face this morning and see things the way you see it. So we come this morning. We're laying it all right here at the cross. We're going to put it all down. Somebody's even wondering right now, how am I going to make it through today? Let them put it down at the altar, Master. You know that you took care, you take care of everything. Even the fowl and the grass, you take care of everything. Let that person know today. Someone is coming with a physical ailment this morning. You've been healing way back. It's all in your record. Let them know that right now they can bring it to you and leave it right there. There's a troubling mind somewhere this morning, not knowing which way to go. But I heard you say, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Just follow me. Thank you, Lord. Whatever it is today, we bind it now in right in Christ Jesus. We take it and we bind it in such a way that we can now bury it and let you have it. So whatever it is that's going on, whatever it is that's been troubling us, We say right now, have your way. Do what only you can do. And we'll be careful to give you all the praise and the glory. We bless your name for this pastor today. We thank you for his family today. We ask you to help him to keep on keeping on doing what you ask him to do. And we bless your word today. Let your word ring forth that it might pierce every heart. And that someone might come crying, what must I do to be saved? Thank you, Father. Thank you, Master. Now we say we give it all to you. Leave it right there. We bless your name. We right now say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen.
Let me also say thank you to our ladies, our women's ensemble this morning. We thank God and appreciate them for rendering praises unto God through song. Also, we want to remind you that this week there will be no ministry meetings, there will be no weekly meetings. All ministry meetings are canceled. We're giving you a break this week. We've had a busy June and a busy July. Amen. And we're going to give a break this week, with the exception of our choir. That's up to Brother Davis. Amen. And our deacons. Amen. We'll still meet this Thursday. Amen. To whom much is given, much is required. Amen. The church office will still be open during normal business hours, but all of our ministry meetings have been canceled. That includes Saturday as well. Amen. St. John chapter number 9. And I'll just look at the first three verses, even though it covers the entire 9th chapter, but for our thought today, we want to look at the first three verses. St. John chapter number 9, verses 1, 2, and 3. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, Neither hath this man sinned, nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. May the Lord bless the reader, the hearers, and the doers of his word. Father in heaven, we thank you again for this blessed privilege to stand in your house of worship behind this sacred desk to share just a word with your people this morning. Our prayer is to encourage every heart, to strengthen those who might be weak, build up those who might be torn down. Encourage somebody to continue to stay in the race and run on just a little further to see what the end might be. We decrease that you might increase. So we pray to let the words of our mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in thy sight. Yes, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Yes, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And we give glory, honor, and praise to God Almighty, who is the head of my life, to Jesus Christ, my Savior, and to the Holy Spirit, my comforter, keeper, and my guide, and to all of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. We thank God for another Lord's Day. Amen. We have come to the close of another month. Amen. This year is over, halfway over. Amen. None of us knew for sure we would be here today, but God's grace and mercy has allowed us all to be here today. Amen. We're here this morning, but there's no guarantee, amen, that we will see the sunset today. But I thank God for right now. Amen. The latter portion of verse number 3 says, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. So today, for just a little while, we're going to talk about picked out for a blessing. Amen. Amen. Picked out for a blessing. Most of us, if not all of us, know what it means to deal with life's ups and downs. If you don't, just keep on living. Now, we've had our good days and we've had our bad days. Some of us know what it means to be on top and then be scraping the bottom of the barrel. If we were honest with ourselves, we've looked within ourselves and pondered the question, what have I done to deserve this? We've searched ourselves to see if there's some grievous sin from our past that's finally caught up with us. Others of us have fasted, prayed, laid out before God, and sought God's face for the answer so that we can straighten up whatever we might need to get past where we are. Anybody know what I'm talking about? You see, none of us like going through the trials that life sometimes brings on us. If we could avoid them, we would. But the choice is not up to us. Nobody likes suffering, whether we brought it upon ourselves or not. Now, one of the things that most of us do when we find ourselves facing life's difficulties is we want to know why. As a matter of fact, when people see us going through things in life, they automatically, most of the time, attribute that to what we're going through to some great sin somewhere in our life. Remember the story of Job? How he lost everything. He lost all his possessions, lost his children, and then he lost his health. When his friends showed up, they accused Job of committing some great sin. But Job maintained his innocence. Now, we know from reading the story of Job that Job was an upright man and one who avoided evil. Now, this attack against him had nothing to do with sin, but it was God allowed. Because when we read the end of the story, we see that God was setting Job up for a blessing. In other words, he had been picked out for a blessing. Now, as I said a moment ago, that most of the time we, as well as people, when they see us going through life's difficulties, we automatically assume that we've committed some sin. But I thank God for Psalms 103 and 10. For it tells us that he had not dealt with us after our sin, nor rewarded us according to our iniquity. I thank God that he does not treat us the way we deserve to be treated because of our sin. I don't know about you, but I thank God that he's not dealing with me the way he could or should because of my sin. I thank him for his grace and his mercy. We see in Ecclesiastes 9 and the last part of verse 11, Solomon tells us that time and chance happeneth to them all. In other words, when time comes, bad things can and will happen to all of us. All you have to do is be living. Amen. And you'll find yourself dealing with what we call some bad things. Now, I must say that sometimes the things that we deal with, the things that we go through in life are directly related to decisions and choices that we've made, and even sins that we've committed. Because Paul tells us in Galatians 6 and 7, be not deceived, God is not mocked. But whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. You see, sometimes the things that we are dealing with in life is called harvest time. In other words, we are reaping what we've sown. Amen, amen. I've never seen seeds come up overnight. Amen, but when you plant them, eventually they will come up. Now, in our text this morning, we find Jesus and his disciples returning from the temple. And as Jesus passed by, according to verse 1, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. Now, there was a Jewish belief that all suffering was punishment for sin. Now, because of the traditions of that day, which are still the traditions in the mind of many Christians and non-Christians alike, the disciples asked Jesus the question, who sinned? This man or his parents that he was born blind? Now Jesus answers them in verse 3, and he tells them, neither hath this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. In other words, Jesus says, from his birth, God set this man up for a blessing. Notice that while this man was set up for a blessing, the works of God or the great thing that God is able to do in our lives will be manifested through his healing. In other words, God uses our situations and our condition to show forth his power. You see, while God blesses us, it brings attention to who he is and what he's able to do. So often we pray and pray and pray, asking God to bless us. But sometimes God answers that prayer by carrying us through something so that the power of God will be seen as he blesses us. Now the disciples thought this man's condition was about sin. But Jesus let them know that this situation had nothing to do with sin, but it was about an opportunity for the power of God to be manifested. The man who was born blind was in the right place at the right time to receive the blessing that God had set up for him. The physical blindness of this man symbolized the spiritual darkness that existed in the world. You see, Jesus came to bring light into the world. In St. John 8 and 12, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. See, when God sets us up for a blessing, it's not just to bless us so that we can stick our chest out and let folk know God has been good to me. But let me tell you something. When God blesses us, it's also to show the power of God to a dark and blind world. As I said a moment ago, this man was in the right place at the right time to receive the blessing that God had set him up for. And we also see that he didn't complain about his situation. So often we complain about what we are going through. We question God and ask him why. We tell God how we don't deserve to go through what we are going through. You see, I know because I've been there. Can I get a witness? Yeah, I can admit, amen, that I felt like I didn't deserve to go through what I was going through. But so often we fail to realize that sometimes God wants to use us in our situations to bring glory to his name. In 2 Corinthians chapter 12, the Apostle Paul tells us how he prayed three times and asked God to remove the thorn from his flesh. He said, three times I besought the Lord that it might depart from me. But God said unto Paul, my grace is sufficient for thee. My strength is made perfect in weakness. Paul said, because of this answer from God, he said, most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmity, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. He said, this is what I've learned. When I'm weak, then am I strong. We must realize that God has a purpose for allowing us to go through the thing that we go through. When God picks you out for a blessing, amen, you might as well get ready, because sometimes you'll have to go through something to get to where your blessing is. You see, his purpose is not to make us weak, but to make us strong. His purpose is not to destroy us when he allows us to go through things, but his purpose is to build us up. Let me share with you a little story. The story is told of a young man by the name of John who had lost his eyesight in a chemical explosion at the age of 13. John said that at that time, he felt that his life was over. He felt helpless. He hated God. He said for the first 6 months, he did nothing to improve his lot in life. He would eat all his meals alone in his room. One day his father entered his room and said, John, winter's coming and the storm windows need to be up. That's your job. I want those hung by the time I get back this evening or else. Then he turned, walked out of the room and slammed the door. John said, I got so angry. I thought, who does he think I am? He said, I'm blind. I was so angry, I decided to do it. He said, I felt my way to the garage, found the windows, located the necessary tools, found the ladder, all while muttering under my breath, I'll show them. He said, I'll fall. Then they'll have a blind and paralyzed son. Can I get a witness? John said, I got all the windows up. He said, but it was later that I found out that never at any moment was my father more than 4 or 5 feet away from my side. You see, when we are going through things in life, when we are facing the difficulties of life, we feel like we're all alone because we can't see God. But can I tell you, He's never far away. He's always right there. Even while we are angry with Him and complaining about our situation. You see, throughout the Bible, we see men and women of God who faced the difficulties of life. And it wasn't because of their sin, but because God picked them out for a blessing and therefore to show His power over their life. Paul and Silas, you remember, found themselves beaten and thrown in a Philippian jail because they set a young damsel free from witchcraft. They committed no sin, but yet they were beaten and locked up. But God's power was seen at midnight when they began to sing and pray. And their chains fell off with all the other prisoners. And the doors of the prison came open. You see, God used this situation to save the Philippian jailer and his household. I tell you, God uses us and our situations to show forth His power. We're busy complaining about where we are, but we don't realize what God has in store for us and how He will use where we are to make a difference in somebody else's life. Peter was thrown in jail and was awaiting execution. When the church went to God in prayer, God dispatched an angel who went into that jailhouse and set Peter free. You see, God showed His power of protection and deliverance through Peter, who was doing the will of God. You see, God used that situation to remind the early church of the power of prayer. I tell you, God knows how to use our situation to show forth His power. Can I get a witness? You see, you don't know what God and how God's going to use where you are right now. But I tell you, keep on trusting Him. And you will find Him working not only your situation out for you, but you'll see Him being a blessing through you to someone else. In verses 6 and 7 of our text, we see that Jesus spit on the ground, made clay of the spittle, placed it up on this young man's eye, and told him to go and wash in the pool of Siloam. He went and washed, and the scripture said that he came away seeing. You see, what looked like a case of sin was an opportunity for God to show forth His power. You see, our choir sings a song, God's going to get the glory out of this. Can I tell you something on my way to my seat? Whatever you're going through right now, whatever situation you're facing right now, whatever condition you find yourself in right now, you ought to give God the glory. And rather than words of complaint, your words ought to be, God's going to get the glory out of this. Can I get a witness? If you're sick,
God's going to get the glory out of this. If you're downhearted, God's going to get the glory out of this. If you're sad and lonely, God's going to get the glory out of this. Sometimes when God picks us out for a blessing, he takes us through. Sometimes to just bless us. But at the same time, show forth the power of the Most High God. I'm glad this morning that I can say right now, God's going to get the glory out of this. You might say, Pastor, what are you going through? You don't need to know that. I'll tell you, keep on watching me, because God's going to get the glory out of this. Amen.
Picked out for a blessing. The deacons are preparing to receive that one that don't know Jesus in the pardon of their sins. If you're under the sound of our voice right now, this is your time to walk the aisle. The sermon has been preached. Now it's a decision that you will need to make. And prayerfully, that decision is about your relationship about between you and a man by the name of Jesus Christ. There may be another that's looking for a church home today. We invite you right now to be a part of Friendship Baptist Church of the Colony. As these ladies sing, we're here to receive you. The deacons are standing, the ministers are standing. Is there one today that's willing to walk the aisle? Is there another? Would you come?
Be not dismayed. Whatever. Whatever betides, God will take care. Beneath his wings of love abide. God will take care. Here.
Thank you for joining us by live streaming for our worship service today. We are now in the process of extending an invitation in our sanctuary, but I want to also extend an invitation to you, our viewers, if you don't know Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sins, that you might get to know him today. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 10, verses 9 and 10, that if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So if you are a non-believer and you would like to confess Jesus Christ, if you want to become a Christian today, all you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, and it's just that simple. You are saved. Also, if you're interested in having us to pray for you, you can visit our website. There's a place there for you to submit a prayer request, or if you're interested in becoming a member of the Friendship Baptist Church in the colony, you can also visit our website, and there is a place there for you to make that request also. But most of all, thank you for joining us today via live streaming as we worship our God in spirit and in truth. May God bless you and keep you, and may you have a blessed week.